Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Gopi Janavallabha, Girivara Dhari. Yashodanandana Braja Jana Ranjana Yamuna Tira Vanachariyam Yamuna Tira Vanachariyam Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrindaya Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare
Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Krishna
Krishna,
Hare Hare.
Loud. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jaya Jagannatha, Jaya Jagannatha, Baladeva Jaya Subhadra. Jaya Gauranga, 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 Jaya Gauranga. Jai 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 Prabhupada Prabhupada
प्रभुपाद की जय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। Concluding session of the last 3 days of discussions on the glories of the holy name, and today we are reading a verse which was spoken by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to a great devotee, whose name is Sanatan Goswami. Sanatan Goswami was planning to commit suicide, and Lord Chaitanya prevented him from doing so. So we will read this verse. The Lord Chaitanya explains how the chanting of the holy name is the best process of bhakti yoga. Among all the 9 processes of bhakti yoga, the best one. Taramade sarva shreshta nama sankirtana niraparade nama laile paye prema dhana. तारमधे सर्वश्रेष्ठ नाम संकीर्तना निरपराधे नाम लैले पाए प्रेम धन। तारमधे सर्वश्रेष्ठ नाम संकीर्तना निरपराधे नाम लैले पाए प्रेम धन। Tarmadhe, of the 9 different types of devotional service, Sarva Shreshta, the most important of all, Nama Sankirtana, chanting of the holy name of the Lord, Nir Aparadhe, without offenses, Nam Laile, if one chants the holy name, paye, he gets premadhana, the most valuable ecstatic love of Krishna. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace is Bhaktivedanta Swami Shri Prabhupada. Of the 9 processes of devotional service, the most important is to always chant the holy name of the Lord. If one does so, avoiding the 10 kinds of offenses, one will very easily attain the most valuable love of God. Purport. So Jiva Goswami gives the following directions in his Bhakti Sandarbha. Chanting the holy name is the chief means of attaining love of Godhead. The chanting of chanting or devotional service does not depend on any paraphernalia, nor in having taken birth in a good family. By humility and meekness, one attracts the attention of Krishna. I am repeating. By humility and meekness, one attracts the attention of Krishna. That is the verdict of all the Vedas. Therefore, if one becomes very humble and meek, he can very easily attain the lotus feet of Krishna in this age of Kali. I am repeating. Therefore, if one becomes very humble and meek, he can easily attain the lotus feet of Krishna in this age of Kali. That is the fulfillment of all great sacrifices, penances and austerities, because when one achieves ecstatic love of Godhead, he attains the complete perfection of life. Therefore, whatever one does in executing devotional service must be accompanied by the chanting of the holy name. So you do deity worship, do cleaning, do book distribution, but it should be accompanied by the chanting of the holy name. The chanting of the holy name of Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. has been praised by Srila Rupa Goswami in his Namashtaka. If you remember, yesterday we quoted Namashtaka, that the 8 verses on the holy name written by Rupa Goswami. So that one verse yesterday also we read, the same is coming today in the purport. Nikhila Shruti Mauli Ratnamala Dyuti Nirajita Pada Pankaja Ai Mukta Kule Rupashiyamana Paritastvam Harinama Samshrayami. Please repeat. Oh Harinam, the tips of the toes of your lotus feet are constantly being worshipped by the glowing radiance emanating from the string of gems known as the Upanishads, the crown jewel of all the Vedas. You are eternally adored by liberated souls such as Narada and Shukadev. O Harinam, I take complete shelter of you. This is the verse from the writings of Rupa Goswami. Next, Prabhupada is quoting Sanatana Goswami. Similarly, Sanatana Goswami has praised the chanting of the holy name as follows in his book, which is called Brihad Bhagavat Amrita. Sanskrit is a little difficult, you can try. Jayati Jayati Namananda Rupam Murare Viramati Nija Dharma Dhyana Pujadi Yatnam Katamapi Sakridatam Muktidam Pranamyata Paramamamritamekam Jivanam Bhushanam Me. It's good. I did not expect. Maybe because looking in the... So, doesn't matter. Please repeat that one. All glories to the all blissful holy name of Krishna. Which causes the devotee to give up all conventional religious duties, meditation and worship. In other words, one who becomes attached to the holy name, he gives up all pujas also. Like you have so many pujas in the home. So they all the pujas, Haribol, Sarvadharman Prati. When some or other uttered, even once by a living entity, the holy name awards him liberation. The holy name of Krishna is the highest nectar. It is my very life and my only treasure. What is your only treasure? No, not your credit card. Probably saying credit card, debit card, no, FDs, property. What is your treasure? Nothing else, Rethiram Prabhu? Nothing else, no? I'm checking him. The next, if you are having in the mobile, please turn it on. This is verse number, Antalila chapter 4, verse number 71. Verse 71. Because the purport has got many beautiful verses. I want all of you to recite the verses. Etanniravidyamananam Ichchatam akuto bhayam Yoginam nripa nirnitam Hare namanu kirtanam. O King, constant chanting of the holy name of the Lord after the ways of the great authorities is the doubtless and fearless way of success for all, including those who are free from all material desires, those who are desirous of all material enjoyment, and those who are self-satisfied by dint of transcendental knowledge. In Srimad Bhagavatam, Yamaraj says, everybody knows who is Yamaraj, right? We have many visits there, so please listen to what Yamaraj says. Etavaneva lokesmin Pumsam dharma parasmritaha Bhakti yogo bhagavati Tannama grahanadibhi. Devotional service beginning with the chanting of the holy name of the Lord is the ultimate religious principle for the living entity in human society. And then Prabhupada concludes by Lord Chaitanya's verse, which is the most important verse of Lord Chaitanya's writings. Trinadapi sunichena taror eva sahishnuna amanina manadena kirtaniya sadahari. Translation. Once you chant the holy name of the Lord in a humble state of mind, thinking oneself lower than a straw in the street, one should be more tolerant than a tree, devoid of all sense of false prestige and ready to offer all respects to others. Such a state of mind, one can chant the holy name of the Lord constantly. Regarding the 10 offenses, one may refer to Adi Lila chapter 8 verse 24.
ॐ अज्ञान्तिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतः पदकमलं श्रीगुरोन्वैष्णवंश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातां सहगन रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपदान् सहगन ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितंश्च नमः ॐ विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामीनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे वंचा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे लिटिल लाउडर प्लीज हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम राम हरे हरे
Very encouraging to see the enthusiasm of the devotees here to hear about the glories of the holy name. To the degree we are enthusiastic to hear and chant the glories of the Lord, to that degree we are progressing in spiritual life. It is said that dharma samuchita apunsan vishvaksena katha surya notpadaye yadi ratim shrama eva hi kevalam. Suppose I am executing all my duties, material duties, spiritual duties, very perfectly. I'm very honest, very behaving on the Shastra. But if I'm not developing taste for the holy name, and if I'm not getting taste for Krishna Katha, then it is Shrama Evahi Kevala. It's simply a waste.
ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನುವಾದಕ್ಕೆ 93.3 ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅನುವಾದ ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ ಎಫ್ಎಂ ರೇಡಿಯೋದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರಾದರೂ ಕನ್ನಡ ಅನುವಾದ ಬೇಕಂತ
ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ 93.0 ನ್ಯೂ ವರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಝೀರೋ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ನೈಸ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಅಟೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ Brahmachari's duty, or in case of devotees in Grihastha Ashram, taking care of family, earning money in an honest way. But after doing all this, if you are not getting taste for hearing chanting, then there is something wrong. Just like if you are going to a destination, you know, and if you are driving, but you are not reaching the destination, then there is something wrong. You know, just like I was going a few months back from here to the ISKCON Bhakti Center in Whitefield. So I was traveling. And it showed me shorter distance. I thought this must be a new route. You know, Google Prabhu is very intelligent. So I followed this. Who was driving? You were there. Devdir Prabhu, you were there. And then we were thinking, Hare, kya Hare, we are not reaching. And you are searching, going, going, going. And And finally we found it was some other bhakti center it was taking. Then we took a U-turn, then we had to come all the way back. So say when we are traveling, we always keep looking how far away I am from the goal. You keep checking how many kilometers. So you should keep checking how much closer am I coming to close to Krishna. It is not mechanical. It is not like time-based promotion. Like in some offices in government or in private, if you are 5 years, 10 years, then you get promoted. Even if you are not doing, simply coming and purifying the seat. I'm not talking about particular, but some places. But here in Krishna consciousness, every moment is a challenge. Every moment is an opportunity for making advancement or for going down. So devotee has to be on guard. Like nowadays, this Kashmir thing is going on, and the soldiers in Kashmir are red alert. So devotee should be constantly red alert. That Mayadev is always going to attack. It's not that will attack. It always attack. The Prabhupada, one devotee said, Prabhupada, sometimes I fall into Maya. Prabhupada said, you are always in Maya. Sometimes you come out. So we should be checking. Am I actually advancing? And how can we check? By how much taste we are getting. Actually, am I heartily offering respects to others? Or am I offering respects only out of formality? Am I actually feeling taste in chanting, or am I just chanting to finish 16 rounds? Am I actually developing love for devotees, or am I just being very formal with them, just courteous enough to get along? So that we should be keeping an eye on our spiritual progress. How to get that taste? So far we have been speaking about that taste, but how to get that taste? It doesn't come just automatically. Just like, not like an online, you know, how to get taste. You click and go to the cart and pay the amount and the taste will come by Amazon.in or Amazon.com or Amazon.goloka, you know, from there. No. One has to make a conscious effort. When we are chanting, it's always a struggle. If you are not struggling in chanting, there are two possibilities. Either you are Paramahansa, which you are not, or you are completely under the control of Maya. The chanting is also such that you are saying to Maya Devi, see, I am chanting, but I don't want to lose relationship with you. I want to be in material world and do some bhakti, because after all, you know, I have come to a good association. So most devotees, including myself, we get into this, it's called comfort zone. Comfort zone. Now I am chanted. I have been initiated. I am in comfort zone. Got comfort. Confirmed. Okay, now I'm chanting, you know, and I'm initiated. Those in family life. Now I'm settled in family. I have two children, and they are growing up nicely. And you know, like the middle age syncrasy comes. In middle age, after the age of 30 or 35, one starts thinking, yes, now everything is okay. While in brahmachari life also, I'm doing okay. I've got saffron color, and many people are bowing down also. And there are many others who are not bowing down, but actually they are my fans, you know. I am very attractive. So like that we get into illusion. But for a devotee who wants to advance, he has to always think that I am actually the lowest of all. A devotee should never be complacent. Should always be thinking that let me use every moment. Like I always, morning I quoted this letter by Srila Prabhupada, Srila Jayapadaka Swami Maharaj, there 1968. He asked Prabhupada, Prabhupada, I want to study Bengali. The Prabhupada said, yes, very good, you can study. But in my opinion, if you have extra time, then try to chant more and more. Chant extra rounds. Because death can come any time, and before death comes, you have to come to pure chanting. How do we go from present chanting to pure chanting? From present chanting, which is filled with offenses, next step is namabhas. That is reflection on the holy name. And third stage is Shuddhana. How do we go from one step to another? Just keep on chanting. Like if I'm on the highway, I have to go from here, let's say, to Hyderabad. What do I have to do? Just keep on moving. Take the highway, the exit will come, airport exit, just keep moving. So many exits will come, but keep moving. So just go on chanting with determination. And then you will attain the perfect result. That is the first step, to keep on chanting. Second is to serve devotees who have got that kind of taste. Mahat sevam dwar ahur vimuktes tamo dwaram yoshitam sanga sangi. By serving great souls, one gets that taste. Matirna Krishna Parato Svatova. By one's own intelligence or even by the instruction of others, one may not get that taste. But Mahat Seva, Mahat Pada Rajobhishekam, taking the dust of the lotus feet of the Vaishnavas. Of course, taking dust doesn't mean physically necessarily. Some very senior sannyasi is going to just catch his feet. I have to go for a program. No, I have to catch your feet. And just, as I told last time, that two devotees, one devotee tried to catch the feet, the other fell down and he was in crutches for 3 months. The first one thinking, no problem, I got the dust. So what does the real dust mean? To follow the instruction of great souls. And all great souls in our society instruct us to regularly chant the holy name with faith, attention and humility. In the mood of a beggar, praying to Radharani and to Shri Krishna, I am completely dependent on you. There is a very nice song by Narottam Das Thakur. Hari Hari Bipale Janam Gunainu. He says in this song that my life is wasted. Manushya Janam Paya Radha Krishna Na Bhajiya Janiya Shuniya Bishkainu. That I have attained this human body but yet not attained love for Krishna. It's as if I am drinking poison knowingly. And then he says in the last line, Haha Prabhu Nanda Suta Vrishabhanu Suta Yuta Karuna Koro Eibara Narottama Dasa Kahe Nathe Liho Ranga Pai Toma Bina Ke Ache Amara. He says, my dear Lord, O Nanda Suta, that is Krishna, and Vrishabhanu Suta, daughter of Vrishabhanu, that is Radharani, Karuna Koro Eibara, just glance upon me, just once. You give me your mercy, then. Narottam Das says, Toma bina ke achi. There's nobody except you. So we should have that feeling in chanting that outside Krishna's name, I have no hope. And with the holy name of Krishna, I have full hope. Holy name gives hope to the hopeless also. So one should serve the devotees who have got such taste. And next is, one should beg for mercy, plead for mercy, yearn for mercy and cry for that mercy of the holy name. One should be like a desperate beggar, plead, just like in the court sometimes somebody is guilty. So he pleads, I am guilty, I have committed this murder, so you will get less punishment. So you plead before the Lord, Krishna, I have been wandering for so many births. Bhuliya tomare sansara bhitare Paye nana vidhi vyatha. Krishna, I've forgotten you and I'm being tortured by material energy. How foolish the living entity is. Although he's tortured by material energy, still he does not give up serving Maya. Nama janmani janmani Maya sevanam. Maya is torturing. Can you imagine you work for, what is the name of your company?
KPM.
So you're working for a company and then after every month you get a salary, right? 7th. What is the date you get?
First.
Oh, very good company. Only thing, if they can give you a check without going, then I'll be more happy. So you can do more preaching. You are a very wonderful preacher. So if the company you work, on the first you go for your paycheck and the boss just kicks you on the face, get out. And then on second you come and says, doesn't matter, embrace me or broken heart, I will serve you, my Lord. Then next month again, how long will you do like this? Maybe 1 or 2 months you may have some faith, but after that you will change your company. The same way we are serving Maya, birth after one birth we serve, we become a dog and death. Then we become a cat, then become a human being, not devotee, work very hard, accumulate a very nice bank balance and so much suffering. You read the newspaper. I don't read newspaper, but in the mobile automatically some news comes and headlines. I never seen any good news. Really, I'm honestly telling you. All news is that there's a fire in the UCO bank, not Punjab National Bank, because Mataji is chanting, so that bank is protected. Even if there's fire, that it will be like you know, the request of Mataji, Krishna will swallow the fire. Pure chant. That news is there, then you find Pakistan, India, Kashmir problem going on, and then you find, you know, Donald Trump wants to place Trump and all. Yes. I never found any news that 50 people are coming together for 3 days hearing the holy name. They should come in the newspaper, you know. Devotees are coming, they are eager to hear, they are eating nice prasadam, that is, that can come. Hardly any news is there. Have you seen any good news in newspaper? At least I have not seen. Maybe earlier I used to watch cricket, so yeah, India won the match. You know. So what? You know, whoever wins, actually, we don't get anything, the players get something. And I know in one case, one football match, one team lost, and the person who was attached to that country, he just, the time there was television, he broke the television. Now, what can television do? There's nobody inside the television, neither the winner party nor the opposite. If you break the screen, you break your hand and you get, people are so foolish. So we are all, I mean, I'm sorry to say it includes myself, we are serving Maya. We don't realize that actually we are being frustrated, we are being tortured. And Maya Devi is a very cruel master. She's compared to a witch. Jiva jago, jiva jago, Gaura Chandra. Kata nidra jao maya pishachya. Why are you sleeping in the lap of the maya witch? We should be awake. Even after we become devotees, even become initiated, doesn't we have understood? Still we are serving maya, subtly. Materially, it's like an externally I may be brahmachari, but internally the mind is always hovering around for material things, for prestige. For brahmachari, the greatest danger is prestige. For grahastha, it is attachment to family members. So, at the same time, you cannot remain without attachment. How can you be in family life without attachment to your wife or husband or children? It's very difficult. So, how to solve this? Your attachment to the holy name should be greater than your attachment to family members. Even Kunti Maharani has says that I am attached to family members. So, we are not greater devotee than Kunti Maharani. But she is praying to Krishna, please cut this knot of material attachment. So while chanting, we are praying to Krishna. Krishna, please, I want to get free from this attachment. Edhana yauvana putra parijana ete ke ache parati tire. This family, children. Actually, you know, the way the attachment works is, even if we have been together for just 5 years or 10 years, you think that never there was a time when I was not there, nor my partner was there. It's like, it looks like an eternal relationship. But actually it is temporary. But Krishna's relationship is eternal, but that we keep forgetting. So, Nama Sambandha Gyan. Nama gives us Sambandha Gyan. The relationship between the living being and the Supreme Lord becomes awakened by pure chant. But for that you have to actually beg Krishna. And actually it happens to all, including myself, that we have very limited time. Like here today we started 5:55 and 7:30 is the 7:45. So we are planning 1 hour 15 minutes divided by 16, so it's 6.85 minutes. So we are very much time conscious rather than Krishna conscious. So, but we have to be time conscious because time is also energy of Krishna. But we have to be more Krishna conscious, to pause and pray. This is one thing which our society needs more, prayer. You know, we often get good results in terms of external success. But prayerful heart, should be praying for each other, praying for those who are suffering, praying for all living beings. You know? I mean, if we have even the slightest advancement in bhakti, when we see some suffering, our hearts should be crying. If you don't feel sorry for others who are suffering, then your practice of religious principles is simply a show bottle, according to Bhagavata. Not only that, oh, if some ISKCON devotee is sick, if you see any living being suffering, if you see an ant suffering, if you see a dog suffering, that should bring tears in your eyes. Or at least, if not tears, at least a sorrow. We pray. And practically everyone is suffering in this world, as I said. The devotee constantly is praying. We should be chanting with that mood. Krishna, please, let all living beings go back home, back to Godhead. Let this fire of material existence extinguish forever. Let everyone come to the lotus feet of Lord Jagannath. And let all living beings joyfully unite in the chanting of the holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. As I'm just about to discuss this, suddenly this page turned and I came to one of my favorite sections where Jadurani Devi Mataji, very senior devotee of Prabhupada, she wrote one letter to Prabhupada that, Prabhupada, on Ekadashi day, I should be chanting 25 rounds. Is that your instruction? So Prabhupada replied, why just 25 rounds? On Ekadashi, you should chant as much as possible. For us, Ekadashi means World Holy Name Week also. That is like Ekadashi, before we are giving emphasis. And then Prabhupada says, real Ekadashi means fasting and chanting, no other business. And when one observes fasting, chanting becomes easier. It's like, yesterday we were chanting and then we were having katha. But after 10 o'clock, once you take prasadam, then it's like Hari Bol. So if you want to chant extra rounds, maybe today or whenever, take light breakfast or avoid taking, just take fruits and chant more. You have to make some goal. If you just say, Prabhuji, I will chant whenever I get time, you will never get time. You know, if any time when you get, when you say, I have nothing to do, if nothing to do, then your mobile will keep you busy. Just see, you know, some office call is coming, notes, actually, notes, Mayadevi, no, sorry, Krishna's notes, something or the other is always there. Have you found any time where you say, I have nothing to do, I can just chant? Is there any slot like that? So many works are pending, you have to work out your investments, you have to think about family members whom I have not met for so many years. You have to think about your neighbors, you have to think about children, you have to think about parents, about elderly parents, you have to think about cleaning the home, you have to think about cleaning the office. But you forget to clean your own heart. If the heart is impure, then how can you be happy? You should be craving by seeing you and remembering. What is your son's name? Neelamadha. Now he's grown up, right? He's here somewhere. Oh, I remember Neelamadha when I met you at first time, he was almost like 6 months old or 1 year. And I remember I used to go to the Prabhuji's home, and then Prabhuji would be going to office and his mother would bring the child down, and the child would not leave the father. You remember? Hopefully now he's a little more mature. And if he's running, the father is driving the car, he wants to come to the car. That's how we should be eager to chant. You know? Chanting means we are with Radha and Krishna. We should be hankering. Hankering. The Prabhupada says here, suspend other business on Ekadashi and chant more. And because I'm saying this, because very soon Wednesday is Ekadashi. Actually, officially our holy name week ends on 24th. But 25th is Ekadashi, that's always part of holy name. The extension is always good. You know, just like businessman always wants to extend the product which is getting good results. You know that this product is selling good, so you give more time. Like in Diwali time, you find the shopkeepers, they are open almost 16, 18 hours a day. You know? So the devotee is thinking like this, let me do more and more. And like now, I think next week the big billion sale is coming, where Maya's products are available for cheaper price, so they can bind yourself in birth and death nicely. Of course, there are good things also. Devotee can use some hearing devices. We take the good part. So, what Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving us is a special sale. It's actually 100% discount. I don't think Amazon or Flipkart gives. If the Flipkart gives 100%, they'll flip over, you know. They will lose their business. They have to pay their employees. So, but actually, Lord Chaitanya is giving 100% discount. The highest product, higher than any, like the best products in the market, let's say Apple laptop, or bigger than Swarga, bigger than Moksha, is love for Krishna. And Lord Chaitanya is giving it at not 25% or 50% discount, but 100% discount. The price he's asking is just sit, put your hand in bead bag and chant. Is that difficult? You don't have to click also, you know. You don't have to wait to get the product. Sometimes you open the product, like one devotee bought a mobile, and when he opened it, it came out to be a soap. It happens sometime, you know, you have to return. I was thinking Maya Devi is like that. She works on packaging industry. You know, she will market one product, but afterwards when you get it, it's, and there's no return policy. Mayadevi, you don't even know from where the product is coming. So we should not get cheated. Actually, we are being cheated by Maya for so many births. But now we understand. I have say yes to Krishna, no to Maya. I want Krishna. I want to chant. I want to chant more. I want to chant attentively. I want to chant with feelings. Like, you know, Mahatma Prabhu, very senior disciple, he always gives seminars like this, that I want to chant. It's not that I am forced to chant. I want to come closer to Krishna. She got convinced that this world is illusion. And the only way to get out is by chant. Like I was saying, family affection is difficult to give up. But if you have a higher taste for holy name, then your love for holy name exceeds your love for family members, love for material things. So that time of death, very clearly you will say Hare Krishna. Like yesterday I was talking to one devotee. I don't know whether he's here or he was in the Golden Star building. Bhagyanath Prabhu, you know. He was here yesterday, you know. Bhagyanath, So his grandmother left the body in April, you know. So this family is very close to me. I used to go to their home, and once the grandmother who left her body was also, I talked to her. So the Jayadev Prabhu's mother, that means Jayadev Prabhu's grandmother left her body. So his mother was crying yesterday. She was saying that, you know, that my grandmother left. But then as she was crying, she was saying, I asked her, how did she leave? She said, she was saying, Narayana, Narayana, Narayana. Like that she was smiling. I said, why are you sorry then? She said, glorious. I would like to go and fall at her feet and pray that I should get such a departure. She actually was saying like this, Narayana, Narayana, Narayana. And she was not calling Ajamil Nandan Narayana. she was calling the Lord Narayana, blissful form of Narayana. So it is possible, you know. And of course, she's traditionally not connected with ISKCON before. But, you know, we should not be so narrow-minded to think that only in ISKCON is the only place where bhakti can be practiced. Of course, certainly the highest realizations are available here, but in other sampradayas also. So she was chanting Narayana, Narayana. Now I may be giving so many seminars on holy name. At the time of death, will I remember Krishna? Or will I remember material things? Like for a brahmachari, it can be a laptop. For a grihastha, it can be family members. They have to be very, very alert. Let nothing come between you and Krishna. Like Prabhupada once, you know, Shyam Sundar Prabhu, Prabhupada disciple, he was given this service of making deities, Jagannath deities, carving the deities. You know, Malati Mataji, the wife of Shyam Sundar Prabhu, she went to Indian store and she found one, what she thought like a doll kind of thing. That was actually Jagannath. And Prabhu, she showed to Prabhupada, Prabhupada said, oh, if there other two are there, you get them also, Subhadra and Balaram. And then Prabhupada engaged Shyam Sundar Prabhu, so fortunate to be directly engaged by Prabhupada. Prabhupada said, you carve the deities. And he was carving, and one day he saw that Shyam Sundar Prabhu had a small butt of cigarette on top of Jagannath's head. Hare Krishna. Different ways of honoring, you know. So Prabhupada very intelligently told him that let not this piece of cigarette come between you and Krishna. So of course then he gave up. So you may say, okay, I've never smoked cigarettes, or at least after being committed. But it's not just cigarette. Anything can come between you and Krishna. It can be a desire for prestige. It can be a desire for associating with materialistic people or even one's own family members outside of Krishna consciousness. It can be property. So how to overcome all these desires? Just chanting. There are different diseases, but the remedy is one. The remedy is so simple that we take it for granted. So Prabhupada is, and one devotee wrote a letter to Prabhupada. He was a sannyasi and he was having difficulty. He was experiencing some agitation in the body, mind. So Prabhupada said, if you are feeling agitation, that means your disease is more. Material disease means sex desire. We can judge how much we are advancing by how much we are free from sex desire. So Prabhupada says, if your disease is more, then the dose of medicine should be doubled. Like in homeopathy. Anybody has taken homeopathic medicine? Anybody knows how to give medicine here? My father just learned little homeopathy by looking at books. So you know, there's homeopathy, you get Ferum Fas, Netrum Mur, Kali Mur. So There you have different strength, like 4x, 8x. If you are having some fever, generally they take ferrum fas, in this one medicine, for cold. But if your temperature is high, then you take higher dose. Or I don't know how it works in allopathy also. Because you cannot increase in allopathy easily, because there may higher dose may have side effects. But Ayurveda also, you can take some higher dose. So when we are experiencing difficulty, Prabhupada wrote, doesn't matter, you are chanting 16 rounds. If you are having difficulty, chant 32 rounds. Then, so we should always be looking at the holy name as the solution. In one beautiful lecture, His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj, I was with him in a very special yatra with Indradyumna Maharaj and Radhanath Maharaj and our some devotees, senior devotees. So Maharaj was explaining that all the problems of the world can be solved by chanting properly. Financial problem. Everybody is wanting more money. Is there anybody known to you who says that I am getting too much money? Tell the boss, please reduce my salary. Is there anybody like that? Must be a crazy person. You know, everybody wants to increase. And not only they are saying false because the demands are increasing, the rates are increasing. But if you are a devotee who is getting taste for the holy name, then financial problem is solved because your requirements naturally decrease. You learn to be happy with whatever comes easily. You know, just simple living, high thinking. You are happy with simple, some rice, dal, some sabji. Clothes also very simple. Like you see most of the men, women here, dressed very simply. I don't find anybody coming in, you know, very gorgeous way. Maybe they are going to some marriage, they may have to do like that. But otherwise, very simple. And what difference does it make, whether you are wearing simple or very opulent? It's not that if you wear opulent clothes, you will get some result. The devotee is happy. Now Jagannath is dressed very nicely. He is dressed nicely, so I am happy. Similarly, prasad also. If you offer nice bhoga, some of the matajis come every day and cook for Jagannath. And I see, they cook and they go away. Sometimes they take little prasad. It's not that they are thinking that, after Jagannath eats, I will get. Or maybe they are also, I don't know. Sometimes I would think like that. I was cooking for Radha Gopinath. And I would make sure that as soon as the offering is over, after I would do the offering, then between the aarti, 5 minutes was there to decide what will go where. You know. So in a neophyte stage, the pujari is thinking like this. But in advanced stage, let Krishna be happy. You have the best preparation for Krishna. And I am happy to see Krishna happy. The financial problem becomes solved. You are happy. Like whether you live in 1 BHK or 2 BHK or 3 BHK, when you sleep, you just need limited space. Né? Suppose you have 6 rooms. So which room will you sleep? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday? You know? Important is HK should be there. Hare Krishna should be there. You know? We should chant Hare Krishna in every room. Then it's worth. Sometimes you want a nice house because you want to facilitate devotees for doing programs. In that case, that is good. But otherwise, for oneself, be happy. And the husband and wife, if they have good Krishna conscious relations, then material things go in the background. Otherwise, the nature is to always ask for more, and you know, the husband is trying but not satisfying, and the relationship are so unsatisfied. But if you don't have material desires so much, you are happy. See, Sridhar Kolavecha was happy. He didn't have one BHK, he had only HK. He had only Hare Krishna mantra. He was sitting in like a kutia, and there was rainfall coming. And there was not enough money to repair the roof. His wife was not complaining, what are you doing, chanting whole day, get a job 9 to 5. You know, he was happy selling banana leaves. He didn't try for, you know, getting upgradation, that my shop should increase. And Lord Chaitanya is Lakshmi Pati, he is Lakshmi Nath. He is the source of all Lakshmi, and he is coming to beg. Oh, please, what is the cost? This is 10 rupees. No, give it to me for 2 rupees. Sridha said, no, if you don't believe me, then you can go to other shopkeepers. Lord Chaitanya said, no, if I have a good supplier like you, I will not go anywhere, but from you I will take a cheaper price. I'm not charging you more, I'm taking little profit. Prabhupada said, that is one sentence businessmen use. I'm making no profit from you. If you say everybody like this, then what are you doing here? You have to cover your electricity expenses. You know? Swamiji, aapke liye koi profit nahi. You know? Sridha said, I make some profit. He was honest. But 50% of it goes to Mother Ganga. Lord Chaitanya said, Ganga! Oh, Ganga is coming from my lotus feet. She is my maid servant. Lord Shiva and Durga, they are my servant and maid servant. And Sridhar was like, Vishnu, Vishnu. What are you speaking? Children, they grow up and become more mature, but you are becoming more naughty. And Lord Chaitanya, he just smiled. And then Srila was thinking, if I don't give him a beat me up and forcibly, better, okay, just take. And then many years later, when Lord Chaitanya had the Mahaprakash Leela, he called for all devotees. He called for Sridhar and said, Sridhar, what do you want? Sridhar said, I want nothing. I will make you the king of a village. You don't have to open the shop at all. It will be enough FD to keep you going for the rest of your life, your children also. I said, I don't want this. Then Lord Chaitanya said, ask for something. And Sridhar said, my Lord, please be peaceful. Generally, it's the other way around. You know, Lord tells the devotee, Shantaro, I will give you peaceful. Now your devotee is saying, Lord, please be peaceful. And Lord said, I am peaceful, but I want to give you something. I'll give you the Ashtas Siddhis. How nice to have, Laghima can become very, very small or very light. Without airplane, you can just fly. Or you have Prapti Siddhi, you just go like this. I want the latest, what is a gadget, or I want some special item, my favorite, let's say, pomegranate. Prabhupada said like that in one lecture. Sometimes the yogis would go for this pomegranate and pomegranate from northwest, like Afghanistan. Because that's famous for fruits and dry fruits. But nowadays, if you aim at Afghanistan, you may get grenades and bombs. Different kind of fruits, you know. It's very attractive, this Prapti, Laghima. You know, you can go, you want to go to Tirupati, Balaji Darshan, you become Laghima, become like an ant, no security, you can just have Darshan. You can be below the security people and have full Darshan. I'm not suggesting this, but it's so nice. If you have some desire, hopefully you don't have, but a thief can just enter into the reserve bank, all the money and steal. It's very attractive. But a devotee says, I don't want. These are distractions. I just want to serve you, my Lord. When you have this consciousness in chanting, then that chanting is pleasing to Krishna. On the other hand, if you don't have this consciousness, still you chant, then gradually by chanting, you will get this consciousness. So in that lecture, Maharaj was explaining that one must beg for that mercy, must pray for that mercy before beginning japa. That's actually fool. Gurudev, I'm helpless. I shakti buddhi nahi. I don't have any qualification. I want to chant. I have heard that it's one should chant always. But I'm not able to chant 16 rounds also attentively. Please, my Lord, I'm so unfortunate. Durdaivam idrisham iha janina anuragah. Because of my offenses, I am not able to chant your holy name. Please to take away all these offenses. Give me shelter. And Krishna will help. Do you think Krishna doesn't want you to chant nicely? If he doesn't want to chant, why is he saying so many instructions? He wants you to chant. You should just have the strong desire that I want to attain perfection. Like Bible says, love God more than anything else. You know? More than food and drink. Love God with all your heart and all this. So the love God means love the holy name in practical matters. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is in this verse, he is telling Sanatana Goswami that among all the process of devotional service, the most important is to chant the holy name. How does it begin? This Lord Chaitanya is in Jagannath Puri after taking sannyas, that is his headquarters. And Sanatana Goswami, who has been a minister earlier, he has resigned from his job, just put into a jail for resigning. And then he was in the jail for 17 months. He escaped and met Lord Chaitanya in Varanasi. And then Lord Chaitanya gave him instructions for 2 months, 60 days, on the bank of the river Ganga, in the Shashwamit Ghat. And then he told him to go to Vrindavan, to build temples, to write books, and to exhibit Vaishnava behavior. Sanatana Goswami, he came back to Vrindavan. And then after a few years, he is coming now to meet Lord Chaitanya in Puri. And Lord Chaitanya, he is thinking after coming to Puri, what is the use? I came for self-purification, but I am committing offenses. On the way, he had some itching sores. He drank some contaminated water while traveling through a jungle. And because of that, his body was filled with sores. There was pus oozing out. And Lord Chaitanya loved him so much that he embraced him in spite of all this pus. And Sanatana was thinking, am I actually serving the Lord? Or am I offending the Lord?
rather I would commit suicide. Rathyatra is coming. On the day of Rathyatra, when Lord Jagannath is seated on his beautiful chariot, I will fall in front of the Rath and the wheel will go on top of me and I will die in a very holy place, in a very holy occasion. He doesn't tell this to Lord Chaitanya, but Lord Chaitanya is super soul. He doesn't need a WhatsApp, it is P app, Paramatma app, you know. It works always. Within the phone is switched off, no network connection, it's always there. The Paramatma in the heart, he understood, so Lord Chaitanya told Sanatana. Dehatya yadi Krishna pai, if you can attain Krishna by giving up your body, I would be willing to commit suicide hundreds of times. You cannot attain Krishna by giving up body, but you can attain Krishna by bhajan, by not bhojan. Prabhuji likes bhojan. Along with bhojan, bhajan also. So, and Lord Chaitanya says, Krishna does not differentiate. Neecha jati nahi ayogya. If somebody is very low born, very financially, very poor, he is not ineligible for bhakti. And it's not that somebody is very high class, very learned, very rich, or having a high political stature, he becomes eligible. No. Actually, it's the other way around. If you have a high birth, lot of wealth and material degrees, you know, B.Tech, M.Tech, Ph.D., M.D., gradually become M.A.D., you know, as you go on getting degrees. So, all these are actually disqualification. They prevent you from chanting Hare Krishna properly. Why? Because if you have these qualifications, you don't think that you are akinchana. For chanting, you have to feel that I am nothing. I have nothing of value, material value. Now, what does it mean if you are to survive in society, especially in the grihastha ashram? You need wealth, you need degrees, you need possession. But like Yudhishthir Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj, they had all the wealth of the world, but still they were humble, like a blade of grass. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was an influential magistrate, but he writes about himself that Amar Jivan Sada Bhaperat Nahi Ko Punera Lesh, that my life is full of sinful activities. I am very fallen. So that consciousness attracts the attention of Krishna. If we have that consciousness. So here Lord Chaitanya is saying, Dinera Adhika Daya Kare Bhagavana. Please repeat. Kulina Pandita Dhanira Bada Abhimana. Dinera Adhika Daya Kare. What does Dina mean? Dina means one who is humble, or one who is in a helpless state. Krishna gives more mercy to humble. That's why when Krishna shows mercy to someone, he takes away all material things. And then the devotee completely depends on the Lord. But this is a very high stage. And we cannot expect it now. But here, it says, Kulina Pandita Dhanira Bada Abhiman, because they have false pride. Scholars, aristocrats, wealthy people, they cannot chant the holy name feelingly. And then Lord Chaitanya says very nice verse. Bhajanera madhe shreshta navavida bhakti. Krishna prema Krishna dite dhare mahashakti. Among all the bhajan, bhajan here means devotional service, there is navidya bhakti. This is the verse previous to what we are reading today, previous verse. That among all the types of devotional service, like hearing, chanting, remembering, you know, navidya bhakti, shravanam, kirtanam, vishnu, smaranam, padasevanam, archanam, vandanam, dasyam, sakyam, atmanivedanam. These nine processes are there. But among all of them can give Krishna prema. But then we come to today's verse. Taramadhe sarvashreshta nama sankirtan niraparadhe namalai prema. He describes all nine are very good, but the best is the holy name. Not only it is the best, it is essential. Chanting the holy name is a necessary and sufficient condition. Have you studied mathematics? All this combination, necessary, theorem, postulates, and all these things I also wasted time, whatever. So, certain things are necessary but not sufficient. Like for example, you know, doing deity worship is necessary but not sufficient. Cooking prasad is necessary, obviously, but not sufficient.
So you cannot say, I'll just cooking prasad, I'll go back to God without chanting. But chanting is necessary and sufficient. If you're just chanting, suppose you are not able to do any service because of health reasons or whatever, still you can go back to God. But if you are doing all other services and not able to chant, then you have to take birth again. The chanting is the prerequisite for all other items of bhakti. In devotional service, when you do deity worship, we chant mantras. Krishna mantra, Radharani's mantra, those who are Brahman initiated, they know the mantras. But all these mantras are nothing but collection of Krishna's names. So Krishna's name is the moola of all mantra, is the root of bhakti, is the holy name of Krishna. And niraparade namale, this word niraparade is very important, means without offense. And yesterday we discussed how to overcome offenses. Every day we chant the 10 offenses and during the day we do the offenses. Morning we say we should not do, and daytime we invariably do. How to overcome offenses? Yesterday we discussed. You were there. How to overcome offenses? Being humble is the general answer, but especially continuous chanting. That is one thing. And second, taking shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Did I say yesterday? Taking shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Panchatattva Mantra. What did I say for yesterday? Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Taking shelter. What does taking shelter mean? Just like when Brajabasis, when there was a rainfall, suddenly it was like Indra was so angry, he sent Samartha cloud. So then the Brajabasis, they took shelter of Krishna. It's not that they were sitting and rainfall, he said, Krishna, Haribo, Krishna, come if you can come. They were like, Krishna, 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 please, oh Krishna, please come. Like that, that mood is there. Like, I mean, just for theoretical purpose, let us visualize. You are in this building, UCO building. You know, what is that called? United UCO, right? Bank. Huh? UCO Bank, yeah. That is basically UCO, right? UCO, yes. So you are in that building for purpose of drama, and you are in that building and fire is engulfing you. How will you remember Krishna? You know, you will not say, Krishna, I am in nice right colored building. There's some red colors coming here. You know, please take me out now. You've been anxiety. So this kind of anxiety should be there in chanting. Krishna, I'm drowning in this ocean of birth and death. Please take me out. In this mood, we should cry out, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. And as I said, that crying out should be accompanied with niraparad, without offense. And what is the way to go overcome offense? By remembering Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the one personality who is most merciful. So by taking shelter of him, you become freed from all offenses. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was testing Sanatana Goswami. And Sanatana Goswami, of course, he exhibited his humility. Once Sanatana Goswami was called for prasad and he came running. There were two ways to come. One way was very cool way next to Jagannath temple, and the other was from the sea beach, which was, the sand was so hot like fire. But Sanatana Goswami chose to come by the sand. And Lord Chaitanya asked, why did you come by this difficult path? Why did you not come from the main Jagannath Dwar? Sanatana very humbly bowed down and said, I am so sinful. If I were to come through the main entrance, some of the pujaris would see me. Just by seeing me, they would become ineligible for doing puja because I am so sinful. So this was the humility of Sanatana Goswami. That's why he could chant constantly. So we have about 20 or 25 minutes. I will just go to this other topic which yesterday we had left off. We discussed about the chanting, the process of chanting, and now I would like to discuss the two, three important items which we could not finish yesterday. One is the perfection of chanting. Prabhupada writes here, when Lord Narasingadev appeared, Hiranyakashipu tried to fight with the Lord, eventually he was killed. And Lord Narasimhadev is so angry, he is like fire. And all the demigods are coming, Brahma is coming, Shiva is coming, Gandharvas are coming, the Vetals are coming. You know what is Vetala? Vetala, Vetala, some creatures. Used to read in childhood that Chandu Baba, that magazine. The Vetals are there. Vikramaditya or something. See, everybody is alive now. When I was saying Bhagavatam, everybody was feeling sleepy, but everybody likes Vetals. No? Sure, some connection. So the Vedas, previously, now you are in ISKCON, so no problem. So they came, still Lord is angry. Finally, Brahma said, Prahlad, you offer prayers. And Prahlad came to offer prayers. How did he offer prayers? You know, he was not proud. Oh, you are all failures. I am the one, see, I will do it. You are all chiller bhakta. I am the Mahabhagavata. You know, you are good for nothing. How did Prahlad begin his prayer? Anybody knows how he began the prayer? You must be knowing. That prayer, you know. Brahmadi Suragana Munayatha Siddha. What is the translation? They could not satisfy you. If Brahma and Shiva could not satisfy you, I am Ugra Jata. I am born in a very low family. How can I be? How can I satisfy you? And then Lord Narasimhadev actually touched Prahlad. And all the contamination was vanished. So Prabhupada writes here, the same result which Prahlad got when Lord touched him, that same result you can get when the Lord touches you in the form of the holy name when you chant Hare Krishna. So that should be our faith, that Krishna is touching. Another story is Aghasura. Aghasura was a big demon. He was a python, 12 kilometers, like from here to Majestic almost. Ne? If Agassur has to go to catch a train, he doesn't have to walk. He just reverses his direction. But if you go inside Agassur, you will not go to station. You will go somewhere else. So Agassur, I mean, yes. The word Agha means pap. All Asuras are sinful, but he is specially called Agassur. Means some special, you know, sinful activity. But because the Lord entered his mouth, Brajabasis, they were thinking, oh, it's a nice play toy. And somebody said, no, he looks like a demon. Another said, if he's a demon, doesn't matter. Krishna has killed so many demons, one more in a hit list. So they happily walked in, chanting Krishna's name. And then Krishna was thinking, what should I do now? And the demon was waiting. The person who has killed my sister and brother, Putana and Bakasur, the transcendental family, Mr. Agassur, Mr. Bakasur, and Mrs. Putana. You know. Even non-devotee demons, they have so much love for each other. You know. That is remembering. He has killed my brother. So when finally Krishna decides to come in and, you know, he closes his mouth, and the demigods are like terrified. The Asuras are very happy, Hari Bol, you know, not Kans Bol or whatever they say. You know. They will not say Hari Bol. So when the mouth is closed, then Krishna, you know the story how he expands himself. And Agassur, oh, it's like you eat something and when it goes in the neck, it starts expanding. You know, what can you can't do anything. So eventually he dies. But then when he dies, his soul is purified and he goes back to God. He gets Sarupyam. The same way our tongue also is impure. When we are chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare, all the impurities are cleaned because Krishna is entering that tongue. So Prabhupada is writing here, there is no difference between the different senses of Krishna. Whatever way we come into contact with Krishna, we become perfect. Then Prabhupada tells another story. The story of Prakashananda Saraswati. Prakashananda Saraswati was a big Mayavadi sannyasi. His headquarters were in Varanasi. And he had 60,000 followers, Hare Krishna. I don't know how he is managing the ashram prasadam also. Ne? We have 100 devotees, Sunday we cook for 100, 200, 300. Imagine regularly 60,000. The cooks will pray, okay, we are going to take another job, you know. But 60,000 people, but all Mayavadis. And Lord Chaitanya did not want to see them, did not want to talk to them. But one Maharashtriya Brahmani arranged a meeting so that Lord Chaitanya was invited and they were also invited. And Lord Chaitanya came in and this Mayavadi sannyasi was sitting, you know, with this tilak like this, you know, like Om Namah Shivaya, very. And then Lord Chaitanya, so humble. just the place where we, you know, in temples or in very cultured families, we find that there is a, outside the home, there is a place to wash the feet. So Lord Chaitanya sat down there, like a very low position. Lord Chaitanya is showing that if you want to teach humility, if others are proud, you become humble. Then the problem will be solved. In whether it's in temple or in family or in ashram, if both people are proud, then the fire becomes enraged. Like Pashupatastra and Brahmastra. But one of them just bows down, then the astra is gone. So Lord Chaitanya is showing, if other person is proud, let me be humble. Lord Chaitanya took the... He is the Supreme Lord. He is the source of Brahma Jyoti. But he just sat down like an ordinary person. And he exhibited his Brahma Teja. Because he wanted to attract the Mayavadis. They want to attract somebody who is a medical person, you tell something about medicine. When you attract somebody who is in cloth industry, you tell him something special type of cloth. So Lord Chaitanya knew that Mulle ki daud masjid tak. So all he knows is Mayavad. So let me say Brahma. You know, the Mayavad say everything is Brahma. Some of them are genuine impersonalists, but some are completely bogus. Like the one person, he would drink wine. He said, this is Brahma, I am Brahma. So Brahma, Brahma, Milino. Brahma is entering Brahma. I said, Brahma, Brahma, Milino, this is your Brahma. It's an illusion. So Lord Chaitanya attracted by the Brahma Jyoti and they came out. Prakasa himself came, oh Maharaj, why are you sitting outside? Please come. And he pulled him by the hand and brought him on an aisas. That Sukriti helped him in understanding the message of Lord Chaitanya. So Lord Chaitanya, then they asked him, you are taken sannyas from Keshav Bharati in such a wonderful sampradaya, Mayavadi sampradaya, nothing. Why are you chanting and dancing all the time? This is for women and children. You are very learned. You should come and study Vedanta Sutra with us. Lord Chaitanya could have said, this Vedanta Sutra, this is Mayavad, I have got Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam. He could have done like that, he knew. But he wanted to behave in such a way so as to attract their attention. He didn't want to just defeat them. It's one thing to defeat an opponent and you are nonsense, you are masculine, you are scientist, you are going to hell, you are, you know, frog in the well, and then that person never comes again. But Lord Chaitanya is showing how to defeat a person in such a way that he does not feel bad. Like doing surgery with proper anesthesia. You know, can you imagine if you go to a doctor, you know, take out the tooth? Sometimes it's very difficult. Just last year I had to take out one of my teeth. Even after anesthesia, the pulling. What to speak, suppose you are doing surgery without anesthesia. Person will die, he'll probably kick you back on the face. You know? So Lord Chaitanya, he defeated Keshav Kashmiri. And how did he defeat him? He didn't just say, okay, I will defeat you. And now I'm defeated, put it on the WhatsApp group. No. He just called Keshav Kashmiri for a discussion. Oh, you are such a great Pandit. See, we are sitting on the bank of Mother Ganga. Why don't you compose some verses about Ganga? So Keshav Kashmiri composed and was like, 100 verses. It's not that he has iPad in front of him or, you know, some Kindle he was reading. Just composed fresh verses. Lord Chaitanya smiled and said, oh, you have composed so nicely, your poem is so beautiful. Except for you, nobody understands. So, he like sarcastic, you know. And can you tell me what are the good qualities and what are the faults? Faults? In my poetry, there is no fault. You know, main sab jagah gaya, main Delhi gaya, main Gaya gaya, main Varanasi gaya. And I have defeated everybody. And you are small. You are a grammar student. How dare you challenge me? Lord Chaitanya could have said, no, I am also. He said, and actually you are a great scholar, but you know, Chandidas, Jayadev, Babuti, these are great poets. And these great poets also, they write, there are some grammatical errors. So please tell me what are the errors. So he asked. Then he asked Lord Chaitanya, which shloka should I analyze? Lord Chaitanya spoke one verse. And he was shocked. I spoke like the raging wind. How could you, you know, repeat one? It's not that Lord Chaitanya switched on the recorder, you know, and he just played back. Then Lord Chaitanya smiled. He could have said, I am the Supreme Lord. How can I forget? But he took an ordinary role. He said, by the mercy of the Supreme Lord, someone can be a great poet. And by the mercy of that same Lord, someone can be a Shrutidhar, memorizing. And the same Lord who gave me the power to compose, that same Lord gave me the power to remember. Sarvasacha Ahamdi. From me comes knowledge, remembrance and forgetfulness. That reminds me of prayer which I spoke the first day, but many of you are not there, so I'm asking you to repeat. Prabhupada told one devotee should pray to the holy name. What is that prayer? Anybody remembers? What prayer we offer? Oh my dear Lord, you are situated in my heart. From you comes remembrance and forgetfulness. Please put me in a situation where I can always remember your holy name. Even if you throw me into hell, it doesn't matter. Let me always remember your holy name and never forget you. So Lord Jagannath has heard your prayer. Of course, depending on how intensely you pray, the result will manifest. So Lord Chaitanya is saying that the Supreme Lord is giving remembrance, forgetfulness. And then he told Lord Chaitanya, you tell me the mistakes. And Lord Chaitanya started. First he glorified the good qualities. But the doctor wants to give medicine also, first give the sweet medicines so that the patient will become friendly. First time give very bitter medicine, the patient spoke very nicely. And then he spoke some faults. He said, there's one fault and there's one fault. And then he said, actually, your whole poetry is filled with faults. And a person who has got very beautiful body, but he has got leprosy spots in the hand and the legs and in the face, what kind of beauty is that? You have used the word Bhavani Bhartur for Lord Shiva. Ganga is coming from the matted hair of Lord Shiva. Bhavani means wife of Lord Shiva. Bhava means Shiva. Bhavani means wife of Lord Shiva. And Bhavani Bhartur means husband of the wife of Lord Shiva. That means Shiva. Right? But it can mean something else also. Please give this book to the husband of the wife of so and so. So people may doubt what's going on. You know? And then he told him to reply. And Keshav Kashmiri was trying to mumble, was trying to open his mouth. But he couldn't speak a word. He was just like paralyzed almost. He was not paralyzed, but he could not speak. And all the students of Lord Chaitanya started laughing. Hari Bol, Panditji, what happened to you? They were. And Lord Chaitanya said, don't laugh. He told them in the advance. He is so proud that if he is publicly insulted, he may commit suicide. So Lord Chaitanya corrected him, but in such a way that he did not feel bad. Then after some time, Lord Chaitanya said, actually it's getting late now. You go back and come back tomorrow, we will continue the discussion. Now he understood that he had lost the match. And Lord Chaitanya understood that he had lost. And he understood that Lord Chaitanya understood. But Lord Chaitanya did not let him publicly feel like that. So he went back home and prayed to Saraswati. And Saraswati said, the Lord, the whom you are talking to, is my Lord. How can I come in front? Today you are getting the real result of rendering bhakti to me. Go and surrender to Nimai Pandit. So Keshav Kashmiri submitted. Similarly, Saram Bhattacharya was defeated. Lord Chaitanya defeated him in such a way that he did not feel bad. And here we see with Prakashananda Saraswati, Lord Chaitanya could have told him, this holy name is everything. This Vedanta is not needed. But Lord Chaitanya said, actually what happened, you know, why am I not doing Vedanta Sutra? My Guru Maharaj called me and told, you are a fool. You do not have the power to understand Vedanta Sutra. You simply chant Hare Krishna. Now Prabhupada writes that Lord Chaitanya wanted to show that in Kali Yuga, most people are fools, including those who are studying Vedanta Sutra. So Lord Chaitanya told that in Kali Yuga, most people are fools. So I simply followed and my Guru Maharaj gave me this verse. He said, keep this verse within the throat. What is that verse? Harer nama, harer nama, harer nam eva kevalam, kalo nastyeva, nastyeva, nastyeva gatirane. In this age of Kali, there is no other way, no other way, except the chanting of the holy name. I started chanting. And as I was chanting, tears started coming out of my eyes. My body was shivering in ecstasy. And I was feeling all the symptoms. Then I went to my Guru Maharaj and came and I requested him. Kiba mantra dila gosai. What kind of mantra have you given me? Japite japite haila pagal. I have become mad. So Prabhupada said, actually he was exhibiting good signs. Nayanam galadashrudharaya vadanam gadgadarudaya gira pulakir nichitam vapukada tavanama grahena bhavishyati. He was actually exhibiting what the great devotees hanker for. So when my spiritual master heard this, he said, Bhala Haila. He was smiling. And Prabhupada writes here that the parents feel great happiness when the child is advancing or learning to walk or learning to talk or learning to read and write. Right? Nila Madhav Lila. The same way, the spiritual master feels great pleasure when he sees the disciple chanting nicely. I mean, imagine Srila Prabhupada and all the disciples, they come to know that here all the devotees are chanting extra rounds, you know, like we did yesterday and today also if we have time, they'll be so happy. You know, so I was requesting to keep this practice once a month, preferably in the temple. Or if some reason you cannot come to the temple, you can do in your home. Just keep one Saturday or Sunday for Krishna. You know, other three you can keep for other temple duties are important, but other home duties can be adjusted. You know, you can adjust in such a way. It's like sometimes people have some important material work, they will adjust everything for that. If you have to go to the bank, you have to go. Some marriage is there. I know in marriages sometimes people take out 1 month, 2 months, Sarvadharma, Parityajya. Not their marriage, some, you know, relatives' marriage. So why not for Krishna one day a week? Or one? What is practical is once a month or twice a month? What if it said 4 times a month? What do you think? Achyanthipo, you are one of the, from very young age, Prabhuji has taken for devotional service from Calcutta, right? 10 years or 15 years. So you should also take the lead in organizing. Eh? Is it possible once a month? How many of you can come together one Saturday a month to chant in the temple? Second Saturday or fourth, which is better? Your bank is closed on second Saturday or fourth? Fourth is better? So which is better, second or fourth? We strive from second because October, this time fourth is not possible. Next time fourth means next Saturday. So can we do second Saturday, October? It is a very auspicious day also, I think. Next to, just after Dashera. I will also try to be there, but even if I am not there, make chanting as a priority. See, if suppose you are, you know, you are doing your office work and you are doing homework, but suddenly you get a fracture, then you have to just go for treatment. You can't say, okay, just I will leave my leg here and I will, you know, I will continue with my work. It's not like detachable hard disk or something. You know. So you have to. It's an emergency. If your child develops some sickness, it's an emergency. The mother has to take care. The father has to come back from office. You know, so please take it. Because when you go back to Godhead, now you may feel that Prabhuji is pushing too much. When you go back to Godhead, you'll be grateful to me. And there by your mercy, I will also be pulled back. Sometimes it happens, we encourage others, but we don't go back to God. So, but I pray that all of you get more mercy and go back to God. Not now, but eventually, when the time of death comes. So then my Guru Maharaj told me, Bhala Haila, very good. And this is the, I would like to end with this very beautiful purport. Please listen. This is about a 3-page purport. Prabhupada says, the spiritual master feels great pleasure when he sees the disciple making spiritual advancement. And Prabhupada writes here, the Guru is saying, Ishwarpuri is saying, my dear child, you have attained supreme goal of life. Now you have pleased me and I am obliged to you. Purport by Prabhupada. According to revealed scripture, if a spiritual master can convert even one soul into pure devotee, his mission of life is fulfilled. Even one soul. Why is saying it's difficult? I'm also theoretically saying Kirtaniya Sadahari and I'm Brahmacharya, I have no duties, material duties or even spiritual responsibility. But still it's not easy. But at least we should try. We try for 64 once a month, at least we go to 32 or 40. Prabhupada says if you aim for the moon, you may reach the treetop at least. So try for some. Try for the highest. If you just try for 16 only, you will remain there. So try for more. And Prabhupada says here, my Guru Maharaj, Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, we see his beautiful picture there on the behind the Vyasas. What does Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur say? He says, if I can sell all the temple of Gaudiya Mutt, all the property, all the mutts, and make 1% pure devotee, my mission will be successful. That means it is so rare. And same way Prabhupada also says that we have so many centers in ISKCON, but if even 1% can become pure, our mission is successful. Hopefully with Prabhupada's grace, all of us can become pure. It's not that there are limited seats. Like in IIT entrance exam, you know, how many people appear? 20?
10
lakhs. And how many are selected?
12,000.
10 lakh fools appear. Materialistic. But why 10,000 are selected? Because there, even though others are qualified, there is not enough seats. But in bhakti, there is no limit. All can go back to God. There is no limit. But we have to have the desire. You know what Prabhupada said? What is the most important thing needed for spiritual success? Desire. Yes, the desire. So finally, Prabhupada says, the spiritual master is not happy when the disciple simply brings money. But the spiritual master feels happy when the disciple makes spiritual advancement. So my Guru Maharaj told me, go on chanting. And now distribute this Mahamantra to others. Prabhupada said, that's the second stage thing that the Guru Maharaj wants from the disciple. That he should preach the glories of the holy name to one and all. I'm come to the last stage of Prabhupada's life. Prabhupada was in Vrindavan 1977. And you know, the last stage is generally very painful. He was not able to walk on his own. He was carried in a palanquin. And then here, some confidential devotees are talking to him. Prabhupada, should we call a doctor? Prabhupada says, no. I wish to die without a doctor. I've earned that only medicine is the holy name of Krishna. All this medicine, injection, prohibition, I do not want. I am simply dependent on Krishna. In other words, at the final stage, this is the only medicine. Bhakti Vinod Thakur says, Enechi Aushadi Maya Nashi Baro Lagi Hari Nama Maha Mantra Lao Tumi Magi. He says, I brought this medicine of the holy name. Please accept this medicine and make your life perfect. In the story of Haridas Thakur, I covered most of the stories, but one story which was left out is when Haridas Thakur came to a home of Raghunath Das Goswami. Raghunath Das Goswami is a great devotee, and his father's name was Govardhan Majumdar, and his uncle's name was Hiranya Majumdar. Any father, uncle, they are almost same level. So they had a seminar on the holy name, and everybody was called, all the Brahmins and Pandits. And everybody was asked to speak. What is the effect of holy name? What is the effect of holy name? What? One said, we get liberation. One said, by chanting, you get free from sinful activity. And then they asked Haridas. Haridas said, liberation is a byproduct. The real effect of chanting is development of pure love for Krishna. So one of the Pandits, Gopal Chakravarti, he became angry. He says, what? You are saying liberation is a byproduct? People perform austerities for thousands of years, they don't get liberation, and you are saying this byproduct of what you are saying is wrong. I will cut off your nose if it is wrong. Haridas smiled. He said, don't worry, I will cut off my own nose. Indirectly, Krishna told him, we will decide whose nose will be cut off. Haridas Thakur explained from the Shastra the story of Ajamil. Ajamil chanted at the time of death the name of Narayan, because of fear of the Yamadutas. He called his son Narayan. He was saying, Narayan, 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 Narayan. Not Lakshmi Narayan, but Ajamil Nandan Narayan. But still, he was given a second chance. The Namabhas is automatically there, just like in the morning, before the sun even rises, all the ghosts and all the thieves and all the inauspicious things vanish before rising of the sun. Before we come to pure holy name is Namabhas, and there also one gets liberation. So this Brahman was very angry. And finally, Raghunath Das Goswami's father, they told him to get out. You are a rascal. You have insulted Haridas Thakur. We don't want your service anymore. He was thrown out of the job. And they begged forgiveness from Haridas. But Haridas smiled and said, don't worry. It's not his fault. He is in ignorance. But very soon he contracted disease and his nose fell down. And his fingers also. So he had to suffer. So, in conclusion, what Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving through Haridas Thakur and to Srila Prabhupada is the highest gift. And Bhakti Vinod Thakur describes in a song how to receive that gift. He says, please repeat after me. Bhagati Vinoda Prabhu Charane Podiya ಸೇ ಹರಿ ನಾಮ ಮಂತ್ರ ಲೋಯಿಲೋ ಮಾಗಿಯ ಭಗತಿ ವಿನೋದ ಪ್ರಭು ಚರಣೆ ಪೊಡಿಯ. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಫೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಹೋಲಿ ನೇಮ್. ಬಟ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಚಾಂಟಿಂಗ್, ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಫೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಆಚಾರ್ಯಸ್. ದ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ ದ ಚಾಂಟಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್, ವಿತ್ ಹಂಬಲ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್ ಟು ಗುರು, ಟು ಪ್ರಭುಪಾ, ಟು ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಆಚಾರ್ಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟು ಹರಿದಾಸ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಿ ಅಟೇನ್ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ತ್ರಿಣಾದಪಿ ಸುನೀಚನ, ಇನ್ ದ ಮೂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಹಂಬಲ್ ಬೆಗರ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಚಾಂಟ್ ದ ಹೋಲಿ ನೇಮ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಎಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್ ಟು ರಾಡ್ ಜಗನ್ನಾಥ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಚಾಂಟ್ ದ ಹೋಲಿ ನೇಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ವಿಶ್ವ ಪ್ರಭುಪಾದ ಸ್ಪೀಚಿಂಗ್ ತ್ರೂ ಹಿಸ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಟು ಹೂಮ್ ಎವರ್ ವಿ ಮೀಟ್. ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ, ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ. ಎನಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್? ಎನಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್? ಎಸ್ ಪ್ರಭು, ಯು ಆರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಪರೀಕ್ಷಿತ್ ಮಹಾರಾಜ್, ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಶುಕದೇವ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ, ಬಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು. Yeah, that is true, but here it is mentioned in the Bhagavatam like this, that whatever material contamination may be there, that is removed. In other words, we know, yes, Prahlad is a pure devotee. At the same time, it is mentioned like this, that if there are any impurities, they will vanish. Any other questions or comments? Yes. Anup. Anup, right?
So many meanings we have, mercy
means connection with Krishna. Real mercy is, of course you can say that also mercy, Lord may give me a better job.
So you say, please give me your service.
Lord may give?
You may please engage me in your service.
Service, yes.
Some thing is, please cut to me. Like so many conditions, which is most important?
The most important prayer is, let my mind be fixed on your lotus feet, my tongue may glorify you, my ear may hear about you, I may engage all my senses in your service. And even higher than that is Vasudev Datta. He was asked by the Lord, what do you want? And Vasudev said, my heart breaks to see the suffering of others. So let all living beings go back home, back to Godhead, and let me suffer for them. That is the highest prayer. And actually Lord Chaitanya told him, don't worry, you don't have to go to hell. What Vasudeva was saying, if they are sinful, you transfer their sins to me. How would you like that somebody transfer your sins to your bank account? You know, it's like somebody just without notice keeps on withdrawing. You will not like. But Vasudeva is saying, doesn't matter if I have to go to hell, but let all go back home, back to God. So that is the supreme prayer. All prayers are perfect in their own way. But this is Prahlad Maharaj, same person has become Vasudev Datta. In Gaurlila he becomes Vasudev Datta. So he's praying like this, please give me shelter. Has that answered your question? Partially? Anything else you want?
When leaving the body, one should be Nirjan Bhajan or Nirjan
Bhajan? One should be Nirjan Bhajan? At our level, association of devotees is better. We may have...
Just after that, almost while leaving the body...
Actually, most of us, when we leave a body, we will not have choice where we are. You know, because we don't know when death comes. But we should have association of devotees. Haridas Thakur chose to leave... He was doing sometime Nirjan Bhajan, but the final stage, he called for devotees. So, we are not so advanced that... You know, when we are Nirjan, we may not do bhajan. The bhojan may take place. Very difficult to do Nirjan bhajan in Kali Yuga. Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur never encouraged. He said, oh mind, you are a cheater. You know, what this, your Nirjan bhajan is simply a show.
Then just leaving the body.
Yeah,
you know that you are really going to die. Some attachment will come and see as a devotee, some attachment will come.
That's why I'm saying, we are not saying that we should be with family members while leaving the body. We should have kirtan. Devotees may come, family member may also be there. But those who are devotees, they should be there. Because at least at my level, at our level, our consciousness is not so advanced that we are all alone and thinking of Krishna at time of death. We are not able to think of Krishna now when the body is good. At the time of death, it's like you know, some machine, like CPU is not working, drive is not working, and it's a laptop, but screen is off, and data cannot be transmitted, and you know, hard disk has crashed. That's our situation. The throat is filled with kapha, and eyes you cannot, many times you cannot even see while you are in the last stage. So, I would suggest the best thing is to be with devotees while leaving them. Very, very advanced devotee may do nirjan bhajan, but for at our level, it's good to do with Vaishnava bhajan, satsang bhajan. Okay, any of the Matajis have any question? Yes, Mataji. Anybody leaves the body, we have a simple prayer that Krishna may bless them, wherever they go, they may get association of devotees. Actually, if you get association of devotees and holy name, it is as good as going back to Vaikuntha. Because of some karmic reaction, they may have to take birth again, but we pray that karma be minimized. So whether somebody is in ISKCON or not, ultimately, everybody is a part of Krishna. And everybody will want to go back to it. In Goloka, it's not like, you know, there's some section is for ISKCON, some for, you know, we are all together, all living beings are together. Like some recruitment, just like we take different flights, suppose they're coming to Bangalore, some come by Indigo, some come by SpiceJet, some come from Delhi, from Bombay. Once you're in Bangalore, you are all together in the airport. You know. When you reach Goloka, it's like we are all united. There'll be Gopas and Gopis to welcome you. And there'll be, actually it's said that when a living being returns, there's a joyous festival. This is a big festival that one living being has come back from Bangalore or from wherever you are. Okay, anything else? Yes, Mataji. Our attitude should be that they are chanting, Krishna will correct them. If you think you are telling them in a humble way will help, you can do. Or if it is something very severe, if they are not chanting at all, then you can report to another senior devotee. So that other senior devotee can talk it with them. Certainly, it will invariably be the case, because it's just not by age the advancement comes. And sometimes, you know, it's like it says, it's difficult to teach an old dog new tricks, you know. With age, it becomes difficult. I am one such person, although I am chanting for so many years, my chanting is many times incorrect. So I tell that, you know, some devotee near me, please correct me. But today I was able to chant well because Sri Gopinath Prabhu was there nearby, you know, and I think you were also there in this. So I had two great souls guiding me, you know, very special soul. So when you have devotees around you, and if you have good relationship, if you are not proud, they will correct you. But as far as you correcting them, you have to follow certain etiquette. Because especially if you are young and the other person is 20 years elder to you, then they may say, "Hey, Baba, before you went to school, we were already grown up. You know, and you are teaching us. Chota bachcha hamare ko sikha rahe. I have seen you in your, you know, when you did not know how to walk and talk." So certain etiquette has to be followed. But if it is really very simple, somebody is not chanting at all, somebody is breaking regulative principle, then we have to report in a very respectful way to the authorities. Okay, I'll just, yes, Ma, the last question. Did you understand what? Actually, the sound is, you are speaking correctly, but there's a mic or something. Or somebody can repeat any of the Matajis. We are not able to worship Krishna.
So nicely, but we can worship Vishnu very nicely.
But Grahasthas, they are not the platform to worship Radha and Krishna because they don't have the purity. But we can worship, they say they can worship Lakshmi Narayana. How much is it true?
You see, what Prabhupada says here, we worship Radha Krishna in the mood of Lakshmi Narayana. That, in other words, Radha Krishna Leela is a Raganuga Leela. It is for those who are on the platform of pure love for Krishna. So when we are not on that level, we may do Radha Krishna, like Radha Madhav, we are worshipping in Mayapur, we are worshipping Vrindavan, Radha Shyam Sundar, but we are worshipping these deities in the mood of awe and reverence. That is called Lakshmi Narayan. We are worshipping Radha Krishna, but with the mood of Lakshmi Narayan. And that's the best is to worship Lord Jagannath or Gaur Nithai. At our level, that is safe. Because in Gaur Nithai and Jagannath, there is no offenses. In Radha Krishna worship, there is a danger of offenses. So unless one is very advanced and guided by the spiritual master, it is better to stick to Gaur Nithai or Jagannath.
But at the same time, you are chanting Hare Krishna.
Yes, the holy name is merciful. So for holy name we chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. But even in holy name, before chanting Hare Krishna, we chant Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Gadadhar. So by we are taking shelter of Gaur Nithai. Even if you go to any temple where there is Radha Madhav, Radha Shyam, first Gaur Nithai will be there. Through the media of Gaur Nithai we approach Radha Krishna. Not directly. Okay?